No, you're good. Makes me want to get back into it. Think you ever would? Just say maybe. Well, hey, if you ever need a playmate, I'm your girl. That's I didn't mean like, yes, you did. You know you did. That's why you're on the dating site. You was looking for me. I didn't mean like that. You know what you did. Rib her a little, reassure her. You know what you did. Hey, this is Birdie Bree, and today we're back with Life is Strange True Colors, and we are going to be playing the new DLC Wavelengths. I know it's been a minute, but we're here now, and I'm really excited for this. Now, if you haven't already, please go check out my previous gameplay of Life is Strange True Colors. Link to the first video will be down in the description box below. Quick announcement though, my room is coming along great. I just need a couple of lights and other equipment. And when it's done, I'll do a room tour when I'm ready. Also, I have made a TikTok. So after this video, please go check that out. They're hella funny. Link to my TikTok will be down in the description box below. All right, the moment we've been waiting for. What is this gonna be about? What is the drama with Steph? I'm not quite sure. So without wasting time, let's get this started. Life is Strange Wavelengths. All right, here we go.
Steph, Gingrich? Is that how you say it? Yeah, that's right. What kinds of radio have you done before? God, let's see. What haven't I done? College radio, small town station, did a couple podcasts, lots of live mixing for my band. Oh, okay. So you know your way around an audio booth. Yeah, totally. Your friend did tell me you were overqualified for this job. I just assumed he was, you know, being Gabe. Right. Well, look, if you can handle it without much supervision, the job's yours.
Awesome.
Now, part of your responsibilities would be managing the record store. Given all your retail experience on your resume, I'm sure that won't be a problem.
Oh, right. Yeah, no problem at all.
Great. So your friend said you quit your band to be here. Can I ask why? Sorry. Maybe that's too personal.
No, it's fine. No big reason. I'm just trying to
step back a little, get over a breakup, do something cool. Oh my god, get over a breakup.
You know, take some time to breathe. This seems like a place I can just enjoy being on my own.
Well, I hope we live up to expectations. Haven Springs is no Seattle.
I think I'll love it.
That's kind of cool to like take over a station like that. Like,
okay.
Oh, wow.
The manager left me a task list for my first day. So that's probably around here somewhere. Great. Here's the list.
Steph, welcome to your first shift. Sorry I can't be there. Here are the basics. Introduce yourself. Use the computer to play the auto DJ. Read all ads on air. Ad copy is on the desk. It's very unlikely, but some folks might call in. This probably goes without saying, but if someone calls, answer. Good luck, Patrice. Okay, simple enough until I fuck everything up.
Introduce myself on air? Huh. Let's give this a shot. What are you supposed to be? Are you the Haven High mascot?
Okay,
Pretty sure the only other time I've used a landline was to call my cell phone. Bet I could get these to stick to the bulletin board from here.
What else we got? Microphone.
Need to turn this on first.
What else we got? All right, and then the mixer.
One of these buttons is the mic switch.
Okay.
What's up, Kind Haven listeners? Steph here.
I don't know.
KRCT's new maestro of music, sultan of songs, tyrant of tunes. You get the picture. We've got some great music coming up for you, so keep it here. You're listening to KRCT.
Okay.
Well, I promised great music, so next up, check out the playlist.
Oh, was I supposed to turn on something over here? Okay.
Something tells me you and I are going to be seeing a lot of each other.
This feels like a simulator. Is that what they're called?
This is Haven's number one indie rock playlist. Pretty sparse.
Oh my god. Today's music playlist schedule import music national top 50. Okay.
It'll do, I guess. Hello. Sorry, computer DJ. It's my turn now.
I just blocked the copyright songs in the settings, so hopefully that'll work. If not, I'll just go back in the settings and just mute the audio. But it should work. Play Paint Me Silver. Play Fall Asleep. Oh my god. Home Folk. What kind of music? Talking Distance? I don't know. Play this. I don't know these artists.
Shaking things up already, Gingrich. Maybe I can play a few more songs today. Now I'm supposed to read some ad copy.
Okay.
That must be around here too?
Right here.
Okay, they want me to riff on these bullet points. So I should probably study them a little first.
I am not going to remember this. All right, what am I looking at here? KRCT sponsors 325, 331. The Black Lantern. Talk up the BL. Include the following. Authentic atmosphere. Good food. Thanks, Jed. Put to work Colorado.com. Putting Coloradans to work since 2002. Key points. Smooth, intuitive job portal. Oh, my God. License, career, expects, match. This is crazy. Used by leading companies of technology and entertainment. Free trial with promo code CRT. Avalanche Ice Cream. New to downtown Haver Springs. Avalanche Ice Cream was founded by husband and wife team Sonny and Angela Avalanche. Please don't call us that. Our last name is Anderson. Our 50 favorite, including classics like chocolate, vanilla, etc. And new flavor experience like candy corn, sweet molasses, and crab ragout. No, what the fuck? Okay. We're good. All right, so.
This is Haven's number one indie rock playlist. Pretty sparse. Take that, Auto DJ.
Okay. What am I supposed to do now?
This? Yeesh, I may have no clue what I'm doing.
Oh.
But the good news is, maybe no one is listening anyway.
I didn't even see all this. To who it may concern, I appreciate the Haven Springs has at its disposal a resource as special as KRCT. Not every town can boast its own independent radio station. However, your programming leaves a lot to be desired. On Saturday, during what was supposed to be your classic rock block, you played Lonesome Ranch. Oh shit, it's playing. Oh my god, hold on. Okay, I just blocked it. I thought it blocked everything. I thought I...
This is Yeesh. Looks like I got here just in time.
What the hell was that all about? All right, let's continue this. Okay, Saturday during what was supposed to be a classic rock block, you played Los and Ranch 3 times in a row. Los and Ranch is not a classic rock song. It's a 60-year-old country western single. And 3 times in a row did the DJ fall asleep. Please consider bringing in some new blood. Anyone who can name a release from the last 30 years, so will do. Best, Leslie Cole.
I may have no clue what I'm doing, but the good news is maybe no one is listening anyway.
Okay. Want to improve your ratings? Here's a tip. Listeners have a DJ personality they can relate to. Yep. All right, so...
Great song. That new DJ really has the stuff.
Well, I can't even hear it because I blocked everything. Oh, I gotta read it. Okay. Do I have to read it in order?
And now, a message from one of KRCT's sponsors, the Black Lantern. Here in Haven, the Black Lantern is known for...
Oh my god, historical decor, bearded property.
It's bearded proprietor. Prefer your dinner served by a man from the 1800s? Then look no further.
I messed it up.
And then there's the food. Try the lanterns.
What? Top-notch burgers? What?
Top-notch burger game. Best burgers for 20 miles in any direction. Bar none. Stop by the Black Lantern today. And tell them Steph sent you.
Okay.
Ooh, I need a break. I'll just step away from the desk for a sec.
Records. Browse. Oh, okay.
I've been meaning to fill out my dating app profile. Steph Gingrich.
Okay.
This is your life.
What would you like to add to your tagline? Something informative, something jokey, a lyric? Oh my god. I mean, a lyric would be cool since she's into music. Baby, I'm a bad luck charm. Oh, man. About me. Musician, gamer, cat lover, impulsive traveler, gay disaster, aspiring DJ. Oh, my God. I think I should put B. It seemed hilarious. Like, she's
next,
desperate.
Gotta out myself as a media snob. It's only fair. What kind of stuff do I want to name drop?
Games, music, movies, music.
And top it off with a dash of what I'm looking for.
Something serious, community, fun. Let's put fun for her. Disaster Queen moved here in a whim to DJ at radio station. Take me to a punk rock show or make me a mixtape of your favorite indie bands. Just want to find a girl I can goof off with. That's kind of cool. All right, let's see. Grace, who the hell is it? Hold on. So much going on. You got Gabe. Okay, Gabe talking to me about this job. We're in a group. Too bad my dude, the D's done. I'm going to get real weird with it. Okay, but like how weird? Real weird. What? What? I am not reading all this. Is he? Hey, home safe. I think it would be best if I blocked your number. It's not personal. I just feel like the temptation to text you would be too much. And I want to let you get on with whatever it is you're doing out there. So bye. This user has blocked incoming SMS messages from your number. Oh my god, Izzy. Listen, if you feel the need to go and just block someone because they're a distraction, the problem is with you. You know, you should be able to mentally handle it yourself and not let other people get to you. It's so stupid. I'm sorry, if people do this type of thing, they're kind of weak. It's one thing if this person was harming you physically or mentally or someone harassing you, but if it's just because someone just want to move on and pursue a career, then... clearly, there's something wrong with you. But whatever. Now we're finding out Izzy's toxic. All right, Jerry, who the hell is this? Hey, we're doing a show at Snot Haas on the 25th. Tigons, Riz, Attack, Old Lanterns, and y'all if you want in. Who? What the fuck? Shit, you haven't heard? I kind of moved out of Seattle. Oh, shit, when? Like, a week ago? Damn, is Izzy with you? Nope, sorry, dude. I don't think DSM is a thing anymore. Damn, motherfuckers in the chat. Oh, I read it wrong. Damn, FS in chat. Oh, God. Mikey, okay. Oh, my God. I hope this is the right number. If the person reading this is Steph. Hey, it's Mikey. Been a minute. Holy shit, hey. Damn, dude, it's been ages. How'd you find me? I had a different number last time we talked. No, I stalked you on Facebook. That's probably what he did. LOL, you're in the alumni directory. Seriously? I know, I thought it was weird too. Man, you've donated $5 one time. Anyway, damn, dude, how are you? Yeah, I'm good. You know how it is. Yeah, actually, no, I have no idea how it is. LOL, no, I guess you don't. I'm still kicking around. Got to grad school, so that's dope. How about you? That is dope. Congrats on grad school. Two, LOL. LOL, no idea. I split. Oh, for real? Where are you now? Haver Springs, Colorado. What is that like? A suburb of Denver? Haha, see? That would be a smart place to move to. No, it's way out at BFE. Long story. Well, if you ever want to tell it, I'm all ears. Alright, is that it? Alright, that's it. Oh, no.
There's probably work for me to do in the store as well.
Fuck, I was supposed to check out the other thing I saw. Oh, God.
I think there was a note for me on the front counter.
Oh my God.
Feel like I'd get along with this woman.
Dear Miss Gingrich, welcome to my store. Lord knows we need a fresh face. And I'm an old bat in a nursing home in Colorado Springs. The Record Traders is very near to my heart. So anything you could do to improve the place, and I do mean anything, is greatly appreciated. Kind regards, Cassia. Some ideas, better decor, better music, fixed vent cover in the back, been falling off for years.
So, if I read that right, Kasha's basically giving me carte blanche. I can work with that. I'll check out those posters. Maybe there's something to spruce up the walls. As for music, I can at least start it by updating the new releases. And, yep, there's the vent. Might as well take a look.
Okay. So this is more like a simulator. I gotta make sure everything's in check. What else we have? Package?
No contact for 2 years. Then this mysterious package? Well played, Mikey.
Oh, should I...
All my old GM stuff. Holy shit.
Oh, wow. Game Master knows, look at your own risk.
Mikey really went for the nostalgia.
Oh God.
Guess I should look through everything. I mean, who am I kidding? I totally would have gone to this tour. My old notebook. Dad must have dug it up in my room and given it to Mikey. Oh my God, this takes me back.
Do not read. Warning: proceeding further will result in character death by sudden and unexplained organ failure. Oh my God. Elamon Cloudbreaker. Sex: male. Class: wizard. Level: 14. Bio: Elamon, wizard of the third circle and honorable advisor to King Tiberius, has felt the call of magic since childhood. born to a peasant folk in the village of Autumn Graves, Elamon hid his abilities for many years in fear of being outcast by the village eldership. As a young man, Elamon grew in boldness, finally leaving Autumn Graves to seek instruction at the legendary Hall of Circles. Now he travels the world in search of knowledge, good company, and a smattering of gold. Abilities, communication, move object, astral projection, ghostly push, Urgo's acid blast, Zael's cataclysmic clone of fire, Chignomi's fire strike of flame. Oh my god, it's more? Campaign ideas, beneath the froth and foam, the villagers of Krendel's Keep know two things better than anyone else on the Widowed Sea. How to catch a stubborn herring with a hook and line, and the taste of a stubborn herring over fire. Life was simple there, and a little slow, and hardly dangerous, until the children started to disappear. It started with the brewmaster's son, then the smith's daughter, then the hunter's nephew, then more after. Calls went out to the monster hunter guilds, but not too many folks make it at all the way down the Krendel's Keep. A good-hearted Krento man, one captain, Dennis Salt, sailed to the port of Rye himself and put forward a plea to the guildmaster. It was then, at last, the call was heard, but would it be enough? Too similar to the campaign in Black Hollow. What the heck does that say? The eternal prisoner, no one can say who built the call. Okay, blah, blah, blah. Oh my god, this dude wrote so much. The perfect city. No city in Kirai compared to the bustling streets and dazzling spires of New Eden. It was not just the wealth, the artistry, or the safety found inside New Eden's walls. No. It was a total absence of everyday evil, disease, hunger, death. The citizens of New Eden raised perfect families and lived perfect lives. Neighborhood and kingdoms were desperate to forge alliances, but New Eden stood alone in all its great perfection. But perfection comes at a cost. Rubies and fire. The locals call it Daughter Flame, but the mountain had older names. Furnace Peak, Crimson Rock, and, if you ask the right wrinkled bookkeeper, Karstas, Elder of Throne. It stretched past the clouds and filled the sky with an endless veil of soot. It also brought many travelers to its base, seeking the legendary treasure within. The Gold King Ozus built the vault in forgotten days and left his two undying sons to guard it. No one can remove a single coin, jewel, or crown from the hoard. No one that lived at least. Nah, this is dumb. This is absolutely stupid. What the hell did I just read? What is all this? Oh my god.
So, need a new Elamon campaign. My old notebook had some ideas in it that might work.
Wait, this was her notebook? This was horrible. Rubies of fire beneath the front. Oh, I was supposed to pay attention. These are different campaigns. Okay, hold on. I'm like, what the hell was this? All right. Okay, I don't know. Oh my god, this fucking thing. I mean, I guess this is better, froth to foam. I mean, the children disappear like the Pied Piper, like, what's good? I mean, I guess we'll choose this. Where is it? Froth to foam. I don't care about this. I don't give a shit.
It would be really fun to reconnect with Mikey. It's been ages. But am I ready to GM a whole campaign again?
No.
Fuck yeah, I am.
Oh my god.
Mikey still got it. Elamon, though, has seen better days. Feel like I'd get along with this woman. I gifted this to Mikey before I left for Seattle. Wonder if I'd even understand half of it now.
Kingdoms and Caverns, Game Master's Guide, 2nd Edition, command not only armies, but the very fabric of your story in the next edition of the World Reowned Tabletop Roleplay Experience. Okay, are we done here? Anything behind this desk? Nothing. Anything in here? Sheet music?
Sheet music too? This store can't make up its mind. Not Kasha's favorite musical, I take it.
Backseated Bingo, a new musical by Horace Grassley, copyright 1970, $0. You'd be doing a store owner a favor. So she's trying to get rid of it for free. Oh, I thought that said Holocaust. Oh my god, my eyes. Hold lift.
Oof. We need to get this sucker filled up.
She's got nothing on here.
I had this melody in my head all night. Finally got out of bed and recorded it.
I can't play it though.
This is actually pretty sick. I guess upgrading from humming to actual music is a good next step. Okay, so what instrument should I play this thing on?
A guitar.
Yeah, I bet it'll sound cool as a guitar riff.
Of course.
Mostly, I'm totally at peace with my decision to quit the band and stay here.
What?
Mostly.
The Seattle scene, the Rady City's number one free weekly, local punk favorite drugstore makeup returns by Bernard Nelson. That's the hard thing about being a two-piece, explained frontwoman Izzy Insurrection. If you lose one person, that's half the band. Denizens of Seattle's punk revenues may wonder what happened to the aggressive sets and black lipstick of drugstore makeup after months of silence. Following an unexpected lineup change, Izzy needed to pull together fresh talent. A new drummer is a punk rock grenade. It's the kick-ass energy we need right now. Whatever. Alright, hello there, Yonder. What? Dad, I don't know what could be more grounded than undead nuns. They are literally buried underground. Did you try Shadows and Whiskeys yet? It's got all that crime noir you love without the misogyny. LOL. Love. Me. P.S. Did you try making the trailer more like a trailer? P.P.S. No dead elk yet, but there's always tomorrow. From George Gingrich to Steph. Oh, there's more? Oh my god. Hello, Yonder. Stephanie. Hey there, sweet. So how is it out there at Big C.O.? Hunted any wild elk yet? I've been buried by deadlines lately. Clients submitted feedback at the last minute asking for their trailer to feel, and I quote, more like a trailer. You got it, boss. Tried watching that show you recommended, but couldn't get past the undead nuns. Do you have anything a little more grounded for me? Love, George. Alright, that's it. Flyers.
One day, bad clip art is gonna make a comeback. And when that day comes, I'll be ready.
Posters. Oh my god.
If any of these ask me to dance like no one's watching, I'm buying myself a drink. One of these might work.
Woman of power. Oops. Wait, what? What is oops? I don't know shit.
That sounds promising.
I guess.
Cool. Shit, that's coming from inside the booth. My first call.
Go.
Better go answer it.
Go. I wish they could run. When that appears, there's a waiting call in the DJ booth. Okay. Come on. Answer.
Hello? You're on KRCT Radio, and you're talking to Steph.
Yo, this the record store?
Depends what you mean by this.
What?
See, this is a radio booth within a record store. And this voice you're speaking to, me, is a DJ who also works at the record store. But this phone call, as I mentioned, is decidedly for the radio. Follow?
No.
Oh my God.
Could I just give you my order, and you can just, like, give it to whoever?
Yeah, why not?
Sweet. All right, I got Goodbye Means Forever by Kim Snyder, Going Our Separate Ways by The Seagulls, Don't Let the Door Hit You by Robbie Rooster.
Okay.
Interesting choices.
What?
No, nothing. Just, who are these for?
My girlfriend. I saw them in her wish list online and decided to surprise her. Buy local, you know?
Yeah, cool. Yeesh. I don't think this kid realizes that his girlfriend is loading up on breakup music. Okay. Look. I wonder if your girlfriend might be sending out some signals you're not picking up on?
Yeah. You lost me there.
All right, dude. Listen. I'm pretty sure your girlfriend's breaking up with you.
How the hell would you know that?
Gee, I don't know. Guess I'm psychic.
Whatever, lady. Screw this.
Thanks for calling KRCT.
Wow. Do I need to play a different record? He's like, screw you, lady. What's he gonna call? My girlfriend broke up with me. You were right. Alright, what am I doing? Banter.
I'm gonna be shaking up the playlist a bit here at KRCT. So get your ears ready for some fresh tunes. And keep it here. This is Haven's number. Yeesh. I may have no clue what I'm doing, but the good news is, maybe no one is listening anyway.
Hold on. I had a message from him. Well, if you ever want to tell it, I'm all okay. Hey. What the? Did you get the package I sent you? Yes, I did. Hell yeah, let's play. It's gonna be awkward but fun. I'm a mad dad, but full disclosure, I haven't GM'd in ages, so temper your expectation. No, hey, I get it. You've lost your edges. Cool. Wow. Okay, tough guy. You're on. Hope you like getting bodied by the best in the fucking game. All right. What else am I here? This? Okay. 41? Mother of two? No. What? Wait. 24, this user hasn't entered a tagline yet. How about, no. You miss every shot you don't take, no. Oh my God. No. Can I? No. Okay, she okay? Are you the one you're looking for? Oh my God. Want to get high and watch anime? Shoo. I mean, I would pick you if you haven't said the high part.
You're kidding.
Alright. Can we get out of the booth? Oh, I can't. I didn't even see the thing down there. Let's see.
Here's a new local business to get excited about. Avalanche Ice Cream in downtown Haven Springs. The variety of flavors they've got is gonna blow your freaking mind. Even their classics are a step above the rest. Prepare to change the way you think about vanilla. So come on down to Avalanche Ice Cream and get yourself a scoop from our good pals.
Oh, Anderson, right?
Sunny and Angela Anderson, the best neighbors a hungry DJ could ask for.
Okay, that was good. Okay, I gotta finish in here. Oh! Oh, God!
Unicorn hunters. Barking up the wrong tree, I'm afraid.
Hey, cutie, we're excited to get to know you. Sorry, who's we? Me and Brayden. One assumes Brayden is like your pet iguana. No, Brayden's my boyfriend. We're looking for a third. Did you read on, bro? What? What? No, sorry. I don't like Sharon. Oh my god. I mean, I did, but... Oh god. I gotta ask. What's the appeal? What the... No, no thanks. Oh my god. I'm not really interested, but I gotta admit, I'm curious. Does this, like, work for you? This whole unicorn hunter thing? What do you mean? I've never really sat down and talked to anyone who dates as a couple. What's the appeal? It's fun. It's a good way to make friends. Plus, I'm bi, and I really love Brayden so much. So it's a way for me to express the part of me without excluding my favorite person in the world. Yeah, I don't know. Sounds like she's just using you, you know, just for sex. It's probably gonna just, break out with you and stay with her man, so...
Is it, though?
Well, fuck you, then. I'm done with her, then. No thanks. I didn't even see all...
Analysis of the sonata form and its relation to musical structure and choice? Whoa. Who's the heavyweight thumbing through these bad boys? Ugh.
Ew.
Oh man, I'm gonna puke. The hell peed on our rug?
Okay.
One day, if you're brave, unselfish, and true, you can be a real guitar. Next up, put your paws together for Nat King Cole. We really need to get some customers in here. These new releases are like 2 years old. Creepy. If we don't have new releases, what do we have?
1990s? Go with the 1990s. They'll bring the transplants in.
It's throwback time.
Yeah. 70s would be good, but it's too far back.
Why, yes, I did put up a poster of cute girls flexing.
Like, I feel like the...
Let's not all act surprised at once.
I feel like 90s was really, like, that time of, like, true, like, grunge rock, you know? Everybody was really going crazy and experiment with things and just a lot of controversy. You didn't really get that in the 70s.
When's the last time someone even used this? Treat yourself this Valentine's Day. Call Fred's snow removal. What the hell?
Okay, so mountains, what's this?
I need to know who's mass producing these mountain paintings for every store in Haven. French cuisine and you? Learn to shred on the guitar in 60 days. Mastering your email? Chapter 1, turning your computer on.
See about this.
All those years of high school set design were preparing me for this moment. Oh, it just needs some screws. Oh my god, that animal's living in the walls.
It's Valkyrie.
Hey, You in there. I'm coming back tomorrow with Febreze and a broom. So consider yourself warned.
It's the cat that she... that was abandoned. I know, because it's from the first game. Not like the first game, but the True Colors game, the main game. Okay.
KRCT, Steph here.
Hey, are you the psychic?
Really?
Yeah, that's her.
You predicted I was going to dump Danny before I did it, right? So you're psychic.
Yeah.
You know what? For the sake of filling some airtime, sure. I'm a psychic. I foretell shit.
That's so cool. Okay, so my best friend for basically my whole life, Tara, and I both got into CU, but then I got into UC, which is my dream school. I know I'm always supposed to follow my dreams, but I'm so scared of what will happen if I go to school without Tara. She's my rock.
That's... are you sure you want to talk about this with me?
Didn't we just go over this? Are you going to help me or not?
Okay. Just give me a second. Damn. How do I tell this girl's future? All right. What am I going to tell this girl? 18, huh? That's a strong roll. So, what's my prediction?
New best friend, even best friends from afar. Even best friends from afar. I mean, it's tricky because it's like, usually when people go to separate colleges, they grow apart and they meet new people that are far more better than their older friends. It's really hard to keep that strong, like, friendship. But when you meet new friends, you meet people that are, like, that are alike with your morals, you know? So, I'll say new best friend. It happened to me. I don't talk to any of my old friends anymore.
Okay. I think I've got something for you. Ready?
Yes.
So... you and Tara had a good run.
Oh, no.
You said UC was your dream school, and dreams are about embracing the unknown. After just a few weeks, you develop an interest in...
wait, what'd she say? I don't fucking know.
Peer-to-peer counseling.
Whoa.
The same unique personality that led you to call me while... your ex-boyfriend is still sobbing in the background, makes you a perfect candidate for wading through the messy emotions of your fellow classmates.
I am really good at knowing what other people should do all the time.
And that's where you meet your new best friend. She connects with the new you, the one filled with passion and untapped potential. Weirdly, her name is also Tara.
Then I don't have to switch my bracelet.
All right. That's all I got. Hope it helped.
I'm not sure, but it was really fun. Thanks, Steph.
Oh my god. Let's play this one. Watch, mad people gonna be calling me, asking me for advice. Is that why she was so good with the advice in the main True Colors? Because when I looked back, I saw a video of in chapter 3 when she was saying she was gonna flirt with Diane. Now I chose Ryan, thinking that she was wrong. But then when I looked at other people's gameplay, I'm like, what? She was right. Like Diane was like, oh, I'm flattered with her. Like what? So her plan actually worked, and not Ryan's. Alright, where am I? Alright, let's read... let's go to this first.
This year's Spring Festival is right around the corner. So, see Eleanor at the flower shop for volunteer opportunities.
That's all you gotta say?
Let's hear from one of our sponsors.
Oh, God.
PutToWorkColorado.com has been putting Coloradans to work since 2002 using their...
Career experts? I don't remember. Oh, God.
Licensed experts. These people are like career Sherpas, helping you scale the mountain of your dreams. But Steph, you say, I'm a unique artisan with a highly specialized skill set. No way they'll have a job for me. To which I say, not with that attitude. And just for my listeners, get a free trial membership with promo code KRCT.
All right, I think that was decent. All right. Don't even mention it. Yo, you're doing great. Give me a call towards the end of your shift for the debrief. Okay. Thanks.
I'll just finish up whatever I want to do and then call Gabe.
Ooh. There's nothing right now. I don't have anybody. Okay, what is this?
I used to feel like something was missing if I wasn't rolling this around in my hand.
Okay, let's go back. Let's leave. Let's see what else is out here, and then we'll call game if we think we're finished.
Eventually, I'll need to get back in the booth.
Okay.
Eleanor knows I kill plants. She willingly sent these to their death. I've had maybe 3 conversations with Eleanor, and she's already giving me flowers. I can see why Gabe loves her.
Steph, best of luck in this new adventure. We're also glad you decided to stick around. Hugs, Eleanor Lech. Chocolates.
That's probably gonna be my dinner. Gabe, your girlfriend is too good for you, man.
Steph, have fun at the new gig. Don't worry, these chocolates are safe for work. Best char. Oh, Chen. Is that what it says?
Gabe, your girlfriend is too good for you, man.
Char, oh. Oh, Charlotte!
The scariest thing about this book is the menacing overdue notice I get once a year.
Daughter of the Looking Glass. Okay, Arcadia Bay Public Library. Oh, because she was in the DLC for the first game. Okay.
Yeah, this place definitely needs an update.
Okay. No, I wasn't done over here.
Some drummers dream of sitting in with the Stones or the Who. I know who I'd rather play with.
Aunt Flo and the Lilies, what?
Give me Aunt Flo over these dudes any day.
Summertime Lounger. Why does the dude in the middle look like Sugar Ray?
If I emptied all these out, I could make a wicked fucking fort. But I'm not doing that right now.
Dad, look at this.
One day, bad clip art is gonna make a comeback. And when that day comes, I'll be ready.
Okay, I think I...
All I see are spell books for bards.
Okay, I think I looked at everything, right? I think I looked at everything.
There's gotta be some 90s child out there looking for a nostalgia fix.
Oh, I didn't want her to put boy bands and girl groups. I wanted her to put, like, rock music like Nirvana or something. I didn't even pay attention. Wow. I mean, hey, whatever can bring the transplants in, like I said. Alright, I think that's it, right?
I don't even want to think about what that animal's done in there.
I think we're done with everything, right?
Thanks for supporting KRCT. If you have any regrets, it is now too late.
Okay.
This? Yeesh. I may have no clue what I'm doing, but the good... You're listening to KRCT, Haven's best and only choice for modern rock.
Alright, are we done? Can we call Gabe? I I had never seen a microphone.
Oh my god, oh my god. Am I caller number 12?
Dude, this job you got me?
It's great?
Turns out it's like four jobs simultaneously, and I'm qualified for maybe three quarters of one? Why did I let you convince me to bullshit my way through that interview?
You know you're on the air, right?
Oh. Oh no.
Avoid situations like these with puttoworkcolorado.com. Elevate your job prospects today.
Rough first day, huh?
So it's not bad, it's pretty okay. It's a lot to look at, but...
Kind Haven listeners, today is the last day of June, and that means we've got one more day to celebrate Pride. One of my favorite promotions this month. Contribute to our Haven Pride mural and get 20% off the Silver Dragon Dispensary. I'm told this discount is participation-based and will not depend on artistic ability.
She's sweating.
But, just in case, here's how you draw a rainbow. Start drawing a circle, then stop. More great music from queer artists coming down the pike. Hold up. I'm getting a vision of the future. It's me, answering your calls in just a few minutes.
It's so fucking hot on a fan.
What's it called? Talking. All right. The heat's no excuse. Hey, you're live. What can I do you for?
Hey, well, I think I might have screwed up pretty big with my son.
Oh, okay. What happened?
You're gonna think I'm a real jerk, but my boy Grady sat me down yesterday and he... I guess the term you'd use is, he came out to me. And I could have handled it a lot better than I did.
You shouldn't talk to Grady about this. What does that mean? Wait, what?
Well, I don't know if a fake radio psychic is who you need to be talking to right now.
No, you misunderstand. I don't want a reading. Anyway, he loves your show. Listens to it religiously, and I thought maybe I could put in a song request on his behalf. Just so he knows I hear him. And I love him.
I mean, this won't make it better? What?
I don't know, man. Coming out is a big deal. And when someone you love doesn't react well, it can be devastating.
I didn't know what to do. They don't prepare you for this in the parenting books.
Okay, you shouldn't
but
have a child.
Do you hear how you're talking about it? Like something bad happened? Having a queer kid isn't a tragedy. Your son is learning to embrace who he is and wants to share that with you. I bet that's one of the coolest things that can happen to a parent.
I hadn't thought of it like that. I guess I have a ways to go.
What's the track?
It's Feelings by Haley Kiyoko. Grady played it for me right before he tried to talk to me. Said it was meaningful to him.
All right. Let me see if I can dig it up.
Thank you. I appreciate it.
Pretty sure we've got that record somewhere in the back room.
Okay. Listen.
Hey, Steph. Your pals at Smolder have noticed you're having a massive dry spell on account of you live in fucking nowhere, Colorado. Would you like to expand your dating radius? What's the worst that could happen?
I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh my god, gay punks and all the punks. Oh my god, what is this? No. She looked like a bitch. This just hasn't entered a tagline yet. How is that? No. No. Man, I don't know. No! I'll heal you if you tank for me. I guess. You two like each other? Okay, message. I was supposed to be looking for a disc, right? Start the conversation, wait for her to make the first move. I mean, I picked her, so I should start the conversation.
Hmm. What kind of opener do I want to use?
Heads up, I fall for theater girls. A simple hi. Digging the sword. I guess digging the sword? Not gonna lie, the Bulbasaur cinched it for me. Hello, you're a rare, precious breed then. You're not the first person to tell me that. Shot in the dark, but do you play... Ugh, whatever. Just say yes. Well, it's actually been a while. Honestly, I haven't kept up in a whole thing. Not even sure what's out these days. Oh man, you're missing out. My group has been playing Hunter in the Void. You play as an astronaut trying to escape from a killer alien. Aboard your craft is a whole system where you gain pathos points and reveal bits of your chat, which is the only way to level up. But the more, okay. She's writing a lot. No, you're good. Makes me want to get back into it. Think you ever would? Just say maybe. She loves LARPing and all that anyways. Well, hey, if you ever need a playmate, I'm your girl. That's, I didn't mean like... Yes, you did. You know you did. That's why you're on the data site. You was looking for me. Shit, I didn't mean like that. You know what you did. Rib her a little, reassure her. You know what you did. You didn't. You sure? Yes. I mean, not that I don't think you're pretty. I do. I just mean... I wasn't trying, like... Okay, she's... Yeah. She's one of those chicks that can't control herself and say, oh, sorry for this, I'm sorry for that. No. It's too much Friday. So Haven Springs kind of out in the boonies. Her population's only like 1,000, 100,000... What? 111,000... Whatever. How do you... know more about hip experience than I do. Oh, it's called the internet. Sorry, it's a habit of mine. I go down rabbit holes. How many open browser tabs? Don't dig too deep. So without checking, do you know if you have more than 10 open browser tabs? Oh god, call it out. It's probably more like 50. Do you hate that? I know it's weird. Nope, weird is good. If anything, not weird is a deal breaker for me. Oh, okay. Like, I mean, it's not even full extent of weird. Okay, back to Haven Springs. Have you thought about maybe moving to Denver? No offense. Dude, I was gonna. But I'm being stubborn. I lost a bet. I don't know. I came here. I wanted to change. I feel like I have to prove myself as good. Okay, fine. But you should at least come to visit. You think, absolutely, Denver isn't perfect, but I think you have a good time, be excited to meet you. Visit Haven. Come visit over here. Oh, hear me out. You could come visit. I'd be like, no, you come. It's not as bad as you think. We got a record store, a dope little bar, and an indie movie theater, and the people are rad. That sounds kind of fun, actually. Oh, shit, except I'm sort of in a play right now. We open this weekend and run for the next 3 weeks, so I'm going to be kind of busy for a while. Hey, that's sick. Break a leg. Hey, try. Thank you. Maybe later then? I got shit to do. Hit me up when you're less busy. I will. Watch her not hit me up. I don't know. What is this? What does this mean? Ghost her! Who's Kylie? Wait, did I ghost the wrong person? Hold on, I need to check. what the Okay. No, I didn't go to the right. Wrong person. Okay. This girl look emo. Just here to get to know people. Okay, watch her talk about she's going through sweet thoughts or something. I'll pick her anyway. Not long for this continent. Oh, God. She's too far away. She's probably like in Australia in the wild or something. No. Colby, 23. Boulder, Colorado. I've been told I smell like a new book. I mean, she kind of cute. Huh? They, them. I guess I gotta bash you two like each other. Oh my god.
Do I want to kick things off or leave it to them?
Leave it to them. Oh! Nice to meet you, Steph. Do you want to get to know each other with a round of merry oh my god. What? What the hell is she talking about? I do, but thanks for checking first. Fair enough. That's it? Ask about music, ask about movies. Oh my god. So what kind of music do you like, Colby? A little bit of everything. I've been on the bluegrass kick. Damn, seriously? Hell yeah, I actually ordered a build your own banjo kit, but I haven't put it together yet. Crap, phone's about to die, of course. Asked about. She's gonna be like, nope. Hey, before it does, want to meet up sometime? Maybe. Yeah, I hate it when chicks do that. I'm swamped for the next month at least. Can I hit you up when things chill out? She probably won't forget about it. It's not like a big thing. Don't worry about it. Yep. I don't have time for this.
Time to deliver good music. From the storage room to the masses.
Hey, what? Okay. Is this the... This is the storage room? Okay.
Haven't been in there much. It's such a mess. Sweet.
Mousetrap.
Ugh. I'm just gonna pretend that all the mice moved out and went to Mouse College by now. Free them!
She needs the keys. I gotta.
Great. That guy's request is locked in here. And instead of a combo, I have four drawings.
Dear future Dave, we had to change the lock combo so past Dave wouldn't slosh Irish cream all over the rare records. Here's a hint. Past Ashley and Luca, St. Patrick's Day 09. What? You know I am so bad at this.
Well, those drawings were meant to be a hint. Maybe I can guess the combination? There are only 100 gajillion possibilities.
I am not gonna know all this. I'll do it later. Stick a bean.
That's not even close to enough stickers. I bet you've seen your fair share of bad haircuts, haven't you? Oh, good. I was afraid we were gonna run out of boxes. Oh, man. Better leave that here or I'll be shaking it on the radio until I get fired. Ooh. Maybe it's time for a little record store archaeology. That must have been some party.
Solby's music is now Rocky Mountain record traders. Jazz, rock and roll, rhythm and blues, folk, country, western. Come to our grand open in 1968 from 10 a.m. to 8 p.m.
Oh, wow.
Oh, wow.
Cradle snack. I think my dad had their record. Kasha ran this place for a long time.
My name's Kasha. You are cordially invited to attend the retirement party of Kasha to be held at Rocky Mountain Record Traders 2004. Wow. LP for Clue.
Damn it, past Dave.
What does this mean, though?
Well played, Gabe.
What?
Now, I will destroy you.
Jesus Christ.
I'll catch up with you eventually, Chen. Anyway, I still need to add the tally for last night's match. Man, that game was something else.
Replay the game? Oh gosh.
You're getting better. I might have to actually try this time.
Try all you want. This is my game.
Pride cometh before a fall, Stephanie. Whatever you do, don't think about Jed in a diaper.
Ugh, dude!
I said not to think about it. Goo goo gaga, Steph! Let me pour you a glass of my top shelf formula.
I'm not listening.
Where, Steph? Where'd you go, damn it? I haven't developed object permanence yet! So, how's the fake psychic gig?
Wait.
Stoic. I admire that.
Oh, damn. What happened, Gabe? I thought you were going to try this time.
My hands were sweaty.
It's the poor craftsman who blames his tool. My first victory on the board. Not gonna make a big deal. Don't wanna jinx it.
Okay.
Last thing I've got to do today is pack up all the pride decorations. Figuring out what should and should not go in this section is the most riveting part of my day. Those shades are undeniably star-shaped.
What? When I say jump bottle spinners...
could be useful. It took me way too long to notice this.
Don't feed animal within enclosure. Oh, because of Valkyrie?
I hate that I actually find this funny.
Thanks, I vape.
Now, if that's not an ice cream cone, I've been very confused my whole life.
What?
I spy with my little eye. Five, eyes? I spy with my little borrowing this for a minute. Fewer, yes, but so many remain. Drew this with Ethan. That kid is surprisingly fun. No reason the story has to end here. Should I draw something else?
Necromancer ambush? Let's do necromancer.
Let's give these kids something worth running from. Nailed it.
Wow.
Say what you will about the 80s. Synth bass was a gift to humanity. Sick GTO. A week after we started the campaign, Mikey printed this new Elemon and sent him to me. And it rules. The great and noble Elemon has been through many hardships. He's lost multiple limbs, died, and come back to life who knows how many times.
12.
But through it all, Elemon has always counted on one thing. Friendship. The love and care of a cherished friend.
Wait, what? I mean, that's nice, Steph, but you know Elemon fights alone. Always has, always will.
I'm talking about your sword.
Oh, carry on.
been working on some villains for this campaign. I may be biased, but they're fucking awesome.
Oh my god, more villains, the Child Sorcerer, blah blah, Oberon. It has spat like a curse, or whispered in fear, or yelled in agony, but it was always the same, a name for something most terrible, most ruthless. Heroes fought and fell against Oberon, regardless of his form. At times he was a great spider, howling with a thousand maws. Other times he was a black stag with fiery horns, but in Karai, Oberon took a whole benign shape, that of a child clad in silver robes and wielding a mangled staff of pine. He began his path of domination anew, gathering his strength from behind the child's hair. What the fuck is happening here? Oh my god. Here, you guys read this. Oh, these are nice. But I don't care.
Mikey's drawing skills have gone from rad to ridiculous since high school.
Yarr, it's a travesty what's happening to them poor minnows. Disappearing from out in front of us like salt in the wind.
I'm terribly sorry to hear that, Captain.
Yarr.
Have you tried looking in the ocean? You do seem to have a lot of that around here.
We've looked in the damn ocean. Will you help us? Or not.
Elamon is at your service.
It takes a lot of work to keep one step ahead of Elamon.
Oh my god. Hey folks, I need inspiration. My principal player is getting obscenely good at guessing where I've hit a mimic. Chest pots, cabinets, weapon rack. He just always knows. So let me hear about your best mimics or traps in general. This is my one vice, okay? Use the Lord Master of Gelshire. I once put a mimic in the last treasure chest of my campaign. Like the literal last chest they found after vanquishing my big baddie, undead alchemist trying to poison the world's mana stream. FYI, highly recommended. Needless to say, the party was pissed, lol, but they never saw it coming. User, Walking Shadow Knight. Last year, I made a request given NPC turned out to be a mimic. His head split open into a bunch of teeth and everything. I probably broke a ton of lore rules, but it was worth it. User. Orsage Booty Shorts? Mimics are lame. Use a cursed mirror and send them to the Shadow Realm. So satisfying.
Oh, wow.
Finally got my feral friend on tape.
That's not...
Wait, wait. There, see? Not a raccoon.
It's Valkyrie.
I could listen to that melody I've been tinkering with.
I hope this isn't copyright.
Not bad, kind of sparse, but I dig it. Still feel like it's missing something, though.
Oh god.
Guess it needs a hook. But what kind?
Something anthemic, something poppy?
Maybe, like, a really anthemic hook. Something that makes you feel like you're putting your fist in the air.
I forgot about the radio station. Oh my god, go back, go back, go back, go back, go back. There's just so much to do. Girl in red. color theory. Let's play that one.
Dang, I'm blowing up today. Should probably answer that call. You're listening to KRCT, Haven's best and only choice for modern rock. Thanks for calling in. You're on with Steph.
Yo, yo, what up? Sorry, I don't know what that was.
What can I predict for you?
I am in serious need of some divine foresight. I'm having my first girlfriend over for dinner with my parents next week.
Dang. Big moment. Are your knees weak? Palms sweaty?
I feel like I'm about to throw up. Yes.
I can see why a prediction is in order.
Yeah, so if you could just tell me that dinner goes perfectly, that'd be great.
I will consult with Mother Fate. Be right back. And by Mother Fate, I mean my D20. Oof. 3? That's really not great. All right, moment of truth. I don't want to give this kid bad news, but I don't want to get her hopes up either. I mean, the D20 predicts disaster.
Dinner is disappointed. Dinner goes up in smoke. Just say that.
I'm getting an image of this family dinner.
Okay.
I'm seeing your family dinner go up in smoke.
Crap, really?
Literally, in fact, the meal gets burnt, smoking heavily and setting off your smoke alarms. Not to be defeated, your parents. Order Chinese food. A delicious spread of General Tso's chicken and stir-fried vegetables saves the evening. And the fire alarm provides a good icebreaker.
My girlfriend loves Chinese food.
You can still taste fortune cookie on her lips when she kisses you goodnight.
Holy crap, am I actually excited for this now?
That's the spirit. Thanks for your call. Maybe now I can start a new show. I'll call it The Dateless Dating Advisor.
Sorry, I was crunching on something. Alright, let's see. Is there more stuff on here?
More to offer than the Black Lantern jukebox. But barely. Bit of a learning curve, but we got this.
It's going up, though.
I'm sitting in a booth talking to myself about pride. Cut off from the outside world is an understatement, but this was a sweet message.
Hi, Steph. Long-time listener here. I wanted to commend you for talking about pride and LGBT history on the air. It's a topic that I'm regrettably less familiar with than I'd like to be. This town can feel a bit cut off from the outside world at times, so hearing from new voices like yours is a breath of fresh air. Best wishes, Edna B. Well, that's good. Oh, God. This is a back room. First of all, a little birdie told me about your psychic whatever that says. What a bit. Wish I thought of that one when I was maining the booth. You ought to think about charging by the minute like the pros. As for the storage room, you have my blessings and my condolences. God knows what's back there. I used to be something of a melosolum when I buried product I was too embarrassed to shelve. That was back when I was still capable of embarrassment, of course. Waking up with your teeth in a glass on your nightstand has a way of changing a lady. Let me know how it goes. K. So it's Kasha. Oh, more. Hey, just wanted to drop you a line and ask about that back room. It's crazy packed and I was thinking about clearing it out. Anything I should be aware of? Okay, so this is from before. This was after, I think. Alright,
You liking today's show? I know it's not that much, but I have the memory of a goldfish.
Alright, I'm just seeing...
Nothing says high-quality radio content like an obnoxious sound effects board. I bet I could use this on air. Let's see who we got this time.
Oh, my God. All right, let's try a Black Lantern. Let's see. Black Lantern.
KRCT is brought to you in part by our sponsors at the Black Lantern. It's been a brutally hot summer, so visit the Lantern and escape the heat with...
They got new popsicles, right?
New popsicles! The kiddos can stain their tongues purple while you enjoy a round of darts and a cold one. And if that's not enough to get you in the door...
Bar crawl?
The upcoming bar crawl will. How do you do a bar crawl when there's only one bar in town? You'll have to show up to find out. Hit up the Black Lantern today and tell them Steph sent you. Dang, I'm blowing up today. Should probably answer that call. You're on with Steph. What can I tell you?
Yeah, hey, thanks for taking my call. So I'll cut to the chase. I have the world's worst roommate.
Mm-hmm. Need to see receipts.
That's a bold claim. Are you ready to back it up?
I'm afraid so. Everything he does is loud. His music, his phone calls. He even keeps the little click noises on when he texts, which is every second. And the smells. I think he thinks that the vape masks the fact that he doesn't shower or clean anything, but it's just like strawberry BO.
Okay. I get the picture. So why are you calling?
So I've been planning to have like a house meeting, lay out all the cards, see if there's a way to make this work.
And you want to know how it plays out?
You are the psychic.
Okay, give me a sec. Sixteen's a strong roll. Home not feeling like home. That's a rough one. So can a house meeting really turn it around? 16 is a strong dice check.
Brothers and Phil, showdown for the ages. Oh my God.
I have seen into the blurry future.
And?
So, you sit this guy down, and you talk it out. The noises, the smells, the vaping, and that's how you realize you have more in common than you thought. A strong bond is forged in late night YouTube binges. He introduces you to the wonderful world of Japanese snack food. You introduce him to the concept of taking out the trash. You two become inseparable.
Yeah, but does he ever agree to clean his dishes?
He does. And he tries. He's still a slob at heart, and he still leaves them out sometimes. He still gets on your nerves, but he tries.
I guess that's not nothing. Well, all right. That's better than I expected. Thanks.
That was horrible.
Sure, dude.
Let's play some music. Even though I can't hear it. Okay, so use.
Time for a traffic update. You live in Haven. There is no traffic. This has been your traffic update.
Oh, I could. Wait, what? Why does it do that if I.
Desperate to know what comes next in life? Give me a call here at KRCT, and I will tell you your future. Certainly not included may cause side effects such as boosted confidence, which can be fatal in rare cases.
Okay, so I'm good with that.
Nothing says high-quality radio con. So glad they sell these in bulk.
Oh my god. Bike trash for bike trash. Hit me up if you ride. I guess I'll choose her.
Even if I had the money, I know a sucker's bet when I see one.
Wait, what? You've reached a swipe allotment for the day. Want more chances to meet your special... Why do you gotta do that for right when I swipe on her? Like, you literally gotta pay to swipe? I'm not paying those $16. Okay, so let's come out of here.
Clipping. Local micro celebrity declared cool as hell. Very attractive.
New DJ Revised Mountain Radio. An independent radio station operated out of Rocky Mountain Record Traders in Sleepy Haven Springs has received an unexpected boost in listenership thanks to the addition of self-styled radio sidekick Steph Gingrich. Founded in 1994, the station struggled to bring in new listeners for years, but Gingrich, who says she stumbled into radio prognostication on a total whim, has changed that. People like it when you let them play the fantasy a little, says Gingrich. KRCT listener retention rates are up 20% since the new DJ tenure. Well, that's good. I'm going to leave. Explore the rest of the store and then try to get in that storage room. Okay, let's see.
If Ducky doesn't pick up his Bobby Darin album, I'm sacrificing it to the big band gods.
Charlotte, guess. Ducky does. Okay. Wait a minute.
If Ducky doesn't pick up his Bobby Darin album, I'm sacrificing it to the big band gods. Have I not unpacked my drums because I still feel guilty about leaving the band? Sex, drugs, and original pressings. Those look like ghosts to me. Grabbing this for reference. If Summer were a person, she would for sure listen to...
Love is blind, but you are beautiful.
Man, that guitar's seen some shit.
Ortega, humble beginnings.
Huh. Chef Betty's senior cooking class is getting popular. Actual Haven teenagers buying signed copies of Baynor is the most wholesome shit I've ever seen.
Nothing. Take a look here. What's this? Thank you card.
It was genuinely my pleasure.
Dear Steph, thank you very much for helping me sell my comic. I'm really happy that it's going well, and I couldn't have done it without you. Sincerely, Ethan and Charlotte. Okay. Oh my god. All this cat treats?
Maybe a handful of these could lure the cat out of the walls. Where's a good spot to put these? Could drop a few treats there. Cats love windowsills, right? Or maybe over there? It's a nice quiet spot.
I think in the corner. The cat probably don't want to be bothered.
Consider it a peace offering. Not the most effective cooling system, but in this heat, I'll take anything. Been getting a lot of folks saying good for you about these, but not so many takers. I thought cats were supposed to be low maintenance.
My cat hates me now. What? A guide for new owners, snack time for kitties. So you want to give your feline friend a treat to earn their trust? For first-time owners, the most common mistake is trying to feed your cat on your terms instead of theirs. Tip, try placing your kitty's food or treats in a quiet or low-traffic area where they'll feel safe eating. Yeah, I told you, they don't want to be bothered. Smart move.
All this labeling is giving me flashbacks to the thankless world of high school stage managing.
Well, I think I looked through every... Did I finish over here?
Now, if that's not an ice cream cone, I've been very taking this to look at later. That's all four records. This is really turning into something.
Melody, guitar, hook, anthemic.
Hasn't been a lot of interest in sheet music. Honestly, if this is as bad as Kasia seems to think it is, I'm dying to hear it. I know it's not that much, but I have the memory of a goldfish. How many sponsors would it take to get some AC in here?
Wait, this weekend I was thinking, what if we did an ad as if it was a... As if... What? No radio drama. I don't have a full story for it, so you could just make something up. But I want it to be about aliens invading Haven and ice cream somehow saves the day. Staff, please just be yourself and mention the flavor selection and our ongoing BOGO Sundays. Angela. What, she didn't like what I said? Okay. Let's do Rocky Mountain.
Let's take a quick ad break, Kind Haven listeners. Are you tired of only getting news about big towns far away? Then you must not be reading the Rocky Mountain Gazette. The RMG's reporters are so local.
Covers. I don't know, shit.
That they're in your apartment? Right behind you. Right now. Eating your snacks. And as locals, these reporters...
Care about what you care about? Okay.
Care about the things you care about. They walk your streets, shop your shops, curse at the same pothole you curse at. If you want world-class, fair journalism, look no farther than your own backyard, the Rocky Mountain Gazette. Remember, today is the last day of Pride Month. I want to give a massive thanks to everyone who supported me and the whole community. You guys rock.
What does that say?
Here's a fun one. Today is National Avocado Toast Day. Or maybe it isn't. It's not like any of you are gonna Google it.
Oh, I just realized it's the combo.
That's all four records.
Okay.
Watch your back, combo.
Okay, I didn't realize the records were for the combination.
So, something hidden in these is supposed to get me in there.
Okay.
Better get code cracking.
Okay.
Let's pop this bad boy open.
Wait, I didn't even read the... Hold on. Okay. How am I supposed to figure out... Records? Okay.
Now, if that's not an ice cream cone, I've been very confused my whole life. Those shades are undeniably star-shaped. Those look like ghosts to me. I spy with my little eye. Five eyes?
What, how am I supposed to figure this out? 3, 4, what?
Damn, that wasn't it.
So I see 3, 4. I mean, this looked like 3, but I mean, maybe I could do 2 because of the angel and the demon. And then there's 5 eyes. Is it, I don't know, is this supposed to be like the order of like when these came out? I wasn't paying attention. Okay.
Finally, I can destroy Mordor and get on with my
day. I couldn't figure it out, so I had to look up a video.
Oh, awesome. Here it is. This Grady kid has good taste.
Okay, let's play it. Yeah,
I can finally get back in the booth and play this record, if anyone still cares.
Yeah, it was ridiculous. I was trying to figure it out, and I couldn't. So I had to look up a video. I guess they go by the order when they came out, like I said.
Need to make sure I've read all 3 ads today.
Okay, let's read the ads. Avalanche ice cream, let's do it.
And now, a message from our sponsors. Your friends at Avalanche Ice Cream would like... Wait. What is that? What is that? Stay with me here, guys. I'll try to describe what I'm seeing. I think a UFO just landed outside the record store. Okay, there's a door. It's opening. The aliens are coming out. 2 of them. They're heading into Avalanche now. Wait, what's this?
Wait, what? Okay.
The aliens love the ice cream. One appears to be raving over the new cookie mobster cone, and the other is enraptured by a scoop of pigs in mud. The aliens are getting back on their ship. They're taking off. Woo! That was tense. I sure am glad Avalanche Ice Cream was here to save the day. Why not stop in and show them your appreciation?
That was the last thing I needed to do on the radio. I still have to pack up the pride decorations, though.
Oh, don't I need a...
Let's check the weather forecast, Haven. The whole week is slated to be hot as literal hell. But we can look forward to spotting a single wispy cloud in the sky for about 15 minutes on Thursday. So keep an eye out for that.
Okay.
Guess when I'm done procrastinating, I'll go get that box ready to hold the decorations.
I might stop after this because I don't want the video to go over 3 hours because it'd be harder to edit.
This place looks great.
It'll take longer to upload. Okay. Did she do it all?
All good things must come to an end, which means every pride decoration must come down.
Oh.
Izzy bought this for my kitchen table. Our first pride together. Cheers.
You look happy.
Just thinking about last week, when the waiter came over and we stopped holding hands just in case. Fuck. It feels good not to worry about shit like that. Even just for one weekend. Eventually, I'll get this hanging over my drum set again.
Happy Pride, Seattle! Real quick, thank you guys so much for coming out tonight to support the LGBTQIA youth shelter.
Also, I just want to say, holy shit! You all have made this the best Pride ever! Literally ever!
We have one more. This song is called Compton Cafeteria.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Signs.
I love these so much. Our lettering was on point. Isn't it weird? The event we look forward to all year basically boils down to sitting around on the grass all afternoon.
And spending way too much money.
And meeting cool people.
And recharging my entire soul.
Word.
All right. Signs are dry. Let's go.
Every time I look at this, I feel part of something.
Why do we celebrate? Why is it so important? For generations, we have had to live in hiding or reject who we are in order to protect ourselves. To this day, queer people live in fear. That is why we celebrate. To show the world that we exist and that we are not ashamed. We are proud. Just having the courage to be here, to be yourself in this world, that is an act of rebellion, of resistance.
I want to be her.
Same. People are always afraid to take the ones Chloe made.
Chloe! The first game.
Check out all these booths pretending they give a shit about us for 1 month out of the year.
Oh, I know.
Come on. It's hilarious. We care so much, we made our logo into a rainbow.
We're committed to hassling everyone, straight or gay.
Would you two ladies like to become proud new credit card holders?
I'm gonna go mess with her.
No, don't. Chloe, I swear to God. Guess a souvenir from the best cousin ever. There are so many flags. I have no idea what any of these mean.
Genderqueer pride, bi pride, pan pride, lesbian pride, bear pride, I think.
I look like a normie. I should have worn something cooler.
Stephanie, you look just like a 14-year-old homo at your first Pride. Just like everyone else here once was. And they all think you're adorable. You don't need to try. You're exactly where you belong.
What the hell am I doing here?
Oh no. Until she beats Alex. Well, it's over now. I took all the decorations down. Okay. So I'm going to stop it right here. Oh, it's Halloween. Okay. I'm going to stop it right here because the video is getting too long and I have to edit it down. Yeah, it's pretty good. It's like a simulator. You know, you just do tasks around the store. You know, you learn about your past and the people you were around. And of course, you know, about the cat and everything else. So this is way before she met Alex. But yeah, it's pretty good. I'm going to end it right here. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please click the like or subscribe button. You can also follow me on social media. Links will be posted in the description box down below. And we will continue with Life is Strange, True Colors, Wavelengths in the next video. Until next time, I'll see you guys later.